Hi everyone, today I want to talk about the healing power of sound and music. For thousands of years, music has been our trusty sidekick, sticking with us through our highs, our lows, and everything in between. It's not only just for entertainment or for fun, music can actually heal us. It can soothe our souls, it can mend our broken hearts, and it can even trigger special memories that we may have long forgotten. And it can also help us bounce back physically. Sound healing isn't a new trend. It's been around the world for ages. We were just in Greece this past spring, and we learned that ancient Greece was all about the music intervals and harmonics, setting the stage for what we now call music therapy. In China, in traditional medicine, they've been using sound in practices like Qigong and chanting to keep our energy balanced. Indigenous cultures also use drums and flutes for healing, while the Tibetan and Himalayan practices, they've been walking singing bowls and gongs in their meditation practice and rituals for centuries. So this is definitely something that it has been used from the very beginning. Now, today, scientific studies are now increasing, validating the benefits of sound therapy, showing that it can reduce stress, it can lower our blood pressure, it can enhance mental clarity. And there's also binaural beats, which involve different frequencies played in each ear, which are also used in therapy to create that beneficial effects, such as in EMDR. What brought this to light is my trip to Costa Rica with wildlife. It's beautiful, but we were also just in a simple yoga room. But when we closed our eyes and she started playing the instruments that she had crystal singing bowls, she had the metallic Tibetan singing bowls, she also had those rain sticks that sounds like the rain, and something else that she used that sounded like the wind. It transcended me into a whole new world. It just felt like I was not where I was, and it was very calming to the body. It was doing something to every cell of my body. Like everything was vibrating. That's what the sound does. It creates vibration within our body. Since we're also made up of water, the vibration that the sounds are creating in our body helps us feel more relaxed. So when I got home, I just knew that I wanted to dive deeper into this and maybe
first chakra.
Incorporate it within my mental health practice. So I bought my own set and learned the basics. There's seven different singing bowls, all different sizes, and each has its different tone to align with each one of our seven chakras in our body. Our crown chakra, our third eye, our throat, our heart, our solar plexus, sacral, and root chakra. And now I use them to calm my mind and unwind when things get a little stressful at work. And my boys, they love it too. And watching my son, Grant, he's such a natural. He is able to blend the sounds together, which is so soothing. And speaking of my boys, I'm really grateful that they also have this passion and love for music as I do. And they both play the piano. And they are both part of their school band and run an orchestra. Gavin, my older son, he chose to play the viola when he started middle school, and just recently he auditioned for the high school orchestra ensemble and made it, which makes me so proud of him.
Hey
And my little one, who just started middle school, he actually wanted to play the drums, but it was very limited. I think there were only two spots, and he knew that he had no experience and was hesitant about trying out. But I encouraged him to go for it anyway, just learn what he needs to work on, maybe for next year. And so he did try out and came home one day and was really excited to tell me that he made it. So definitely am proud of them and grateful that they both are incorporating music in their everyday lives. Sometimes their friends would come over and they would, you know, jam, which is so fun to watch. I think there's just something about listening to live music and, you know, have always wished that I could play an instrument, but I just never had the opportunity to learn when I was younger. And watching my boys jam together, I kind of want to join in. So for the summer, I took it upon myself and with my youngest to learn the ukulele. It just started a couple weeks ago, and I'm just really enjoying it. I'm really hoping that I'd get to join them in their jam session. I'll keep you all posted with that one. So music truly is something that binds people together. And having music in our home, to me, is a gift, especially in our fast-paced world, when everything is just moving so fast, and with AI and, you know, everything that's being invented that just speeds everything up, we forget to slow down and enjoy the simple things in life. I'm reflecting on another story where I'm standing in an event hall in front of my family, in front of my parents and friends. And it's my parents' anniversary. We're celebrating their anniversary, and I'm about to sing for them. I'm not a singer, but I love to sing. But if you ask my sisters, my five sisters, they tell you I'm more of a loud, nonstop noise machine than a singer. And they have told me to zip it more times than I can count. But hey, singing makes me feel amazing, and they can't stop me. So here I am about to perform for my parents, but it's never about the performance. I think whether I'm belting out Mariah Carey in the car or in the shower or, you know, hogging the karaoke mic, singing just brings it out of me. I'm just kind of present in that moment where it's just the song and myself. It's almost like it opens a window to my soul, and it's incredibly therapeutic, bringing out all the emotions that I didn't even know were lurking inside. And when I sing, I'm fully present, wrapped up in just in that melody and the emotions that it stirs up. And it's because of this fact that when we sing, our brains, it releases endorphins and oxytocin, the ultimate feel-good hormones, and these magical chemicals help reduce stress and elevate our mood. that just explains it. That why I feel really good after singing or when I'm singing. But also, singing connects us to our deepest emotions and also to the people that we're singing with. There's actually a study where singing together can result in your heartbeats being synchronized. You form a bond with the people that you sing with. I think that's pretty powerful, right? So next time that you feel the urge to sing, just go for it. Even if your siblings tell you to be quiet, go out and sing your heart out. Who cares what people think? I encourage you to embrace music in your life, just as I do. It's so good for your mental health. Let it fill your home. Listen to music. Sing. Play an instrument. If you don't know how, learn. Just allow music to take over and feel those wonderful endorphins do their thing. Feel that healing power that music holds within you. And that is all I have for you today. I hope you found this helpful. Please comment below and let me know what works for you. If you resonate at all with the stories on this podcast and you're thinking about a change in your current situation, in your career, in your relationship, or maybe even in yourself, what's holding you back from taking the first step? Find out by taking the What's Your Biggest Self-Sabotage quiz that you can find on my website at mariagracewolf.com. Until next time, stay kind and own your journey. Thank you again for your time today. If you enjoy this podcast, please be sure to hit subscribe, rate, and review. I would so appreciate it. The high rate and reviews will help others find the podcast so we can amplify, normalize, and break the mental health stigma. This podcast is designed to provide accurate and authoritative information in regards to the subject matter covered. This is given with the understanding that neither the host nor the guest are providing legal, mental health, or other professional information. If you need a professional, you should find one. This podcast does not substitute for personal professional services.